What does a Krobo man in Ghana, a woman who suffered four heartbreaks in Kenya, and one who found love in a valley in South Africa's Cape Province have in common? Three things: cocoa, coffee, and citrus. Not in that order. But first, Dodwa, a small town in western Ghana. There is Bismarck Kwaku. He's many things. He's Ghanaian, he's a father, husband, and a proud cocoa farmer. But Kwaku was never really a farmer. He was a graduate of human resource management. But having grown up in a farming family, sometimes who you are is stronger than who you want to become. So when Coco starts calling you, well, you have to answer. And he did. He got a small farm and started toiling and tilling. But a degree in human resources means little in the farm, he soon discovered, facing a myriad of challenges. Lucky for him, another farmer he met at the market told him, "Kwaku, you can't do this alone. There are guys who help people like us to farm. Come to town next week Thursday and meet them." The following week Thursday, Kwaku met Fairtrade, who are helping farmers farm in a smarter way. He does what a Krobo does: learns about farming, he attends seminars, asks questions, and then he goes back to Manya, where he hails from. He puts this knowledge in the ground. Then he joined the cooperative run by Fairtrade, which gave farmers like him great premiums that enabled farmers to reach their goals, such as improving their farming, businesses, or health and education in their community. His farming has blossomed. His life is better for it. He's a proud Krobo because the pride of a Krobo is in fending for his family, tilling his land. And it pays off. He's building a big house for his family. A house so big, his neighbors can see the tip of its roof from the market. They point at it and ask, "Is that Kwaku's home?" And that's pride. Pride of a Krobo. Talking of beacons of society, some 6,000 kilometers away in a small coffee village in Kenya is Evelyn Yawera, who is also being pointed at by villagers who whisper in reverence because she's gone through a grinder of life. When her businesses in the city ended and then her marriage ended, she packed her things in a bag and went back to the only place she could be accepted, home, to mom and pop, also farmers. Village life was different, but this is where she grew up, amongst coffee trees, blue skies, and the freedom of life. There, she started building her life from scratch, brick by brick. She tried her hand at many businesses. She tried quail business, failed. She tried rabbit business, another fail. Meanwhile, her mother had started growing coffee and excelling at it. During her childhood, nobody dared farm coffee. It was a loss. Coffee had a bad rap. One day, her mother said, "There are these guys called Fairtrade, looking to train youth on how to grow coffee. Interested?" She already had many heartbreaks and was thinking, what's the worst that could happen? So she went, and her life changed. She started with 300 coffee trees that kept growing. She attended Fairtrade seminars. She bought land. She planted more coffee trees. A newspaper wrote about her story. Now, she teaches youth on good farming practices. People point at her. The wind of change blew right into her life. Talking of wind, over in the Southern Cape of South Africa, the wind of love was blowing into Madel Mouton's life when she fell in love with a boy in her small town. If there's a charmed place to fall in love, it must be Citrusdale Valley, featuring orchards of citrus and a smattering of vineyards. It's a small town, about 20,000 people, mostly farmers. We are talking about proud, good, honest farmers. She married him and joined his 35-year-old family business, Mouton Citrus Limited, a farm spanning 1,400 hectares that produce citrus fruit and rooibos tea. They even had a motto: leaders in our field, farmers at heart. Because sometimes life gives you two loves. She found another love in working with workers, empowering them. They targeted the 400 permanent workers and some 2,000 seasonal workers. Fairtrade Africa, transformative, resilient, impact.